We're Ellie and Luke. Oh, and that's Murphy. Last year, we started a YouTube channel to document our search for a slice of paradise in a pretty neat spot. Northern Idaho. In fact, that's where we got the name. North Idaho Nomads. Flash forward a year, we searched high and low, far and wide for the perfect property. We crossed mountains, valleys, and even had some other adventures along the way. We had some struggles, and
there's just nothing left.
And we almost threw in the towel a few times.
I think we should rename this YouTube channel Ellie and Luke driving around in their truck talking about how expensive land is, because that's pretty much all that we do here.
But we stayed the course and continued to search. And then we found it.
Dude.
What the fuck?
Have you ever seen anything like this?
No. Nestled in the mountains and forgotten to time, this old abandoned homestead was just waiting for new life. It's not much, but it's ours. Surrounded by nothing but forest, blue skies, and freedom. We've got a lot of work to do. But that's what we've got season two for.
Okay, so we just pulled in. Truck and trailer made it up the hill okay. Getting settled in, the sun's gone down behind the mountains. And we're gonna spend the next couple nights out on our property. So, fun fact.
Come on, buddy.
This is actually not our first night being on our property, but it is gonna be the first time you're gonna see footage of it. And the reason for that is earlier this week, my external hard drive that contains all of my videos from 2021, including our first night on the property, died. Totally died. Lost everything. So, that's why there's no footage. I guess I should clarify. I was able to salvage really low quality GoPro footage, and that was it. So, since you missed what we did last weekend, here's a quick little montage of what we actually did.
We started by renting an excavator with the intent of trying to level out our future driveway. It took the full 2 days. We also tried to do a little cleanup of all the tires while we were at it.
So I got the front tires cleaned up. I guess I'll just start it on these guys.
While Luke was doing that, I started the cleanup process of the old homestead that was left behind. That's me wrestling with about 50 feet of old chicken wire. We even found some past remnants of the old owners. I tested my limits with some old fencing and gates that were left around. But eventually I persevered and got it. It was a long, work-filled weekend.
And that's what we did last weekend. Tomorrow, we're gonna be working on clearing a lot of these willows if we can. We have a new chainsaw, and then we brought some rakes, hand tools, probably just do a little more smoothing of the road that you just watched us put in. It's gonna be a good one. It's really pretty. It's a really nice night here. Totally quiet. We can hear a bird. It's awesome. Howdy.
What?
I'm gonna give a tour of our home on wheels.
That's it. Let me turn on the light.
I have the hiccups, sorry. Got a lot of step.
Ta-da. Bathroom, closet, bed, couch, refrigerator. All conveniently located within arm's reach. It's tiny, but...
How long have you had it?
5 years. Lived in it for one. Now it's being used for what it was intended. Little bathroom, little shower, little tub, little everything. This was my bathroom and my shower and my closet.
All at the same time.
All at the same time. It's not much.
We even have a linen closet, a pantry. Now that you've seen our humble abode, I think we're not going to really do anything tonight. It's getting dark. We're just going to relax for a little bit and get started on the fun stuff tomorrow.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. All right. Well, we woke up. It's a beautiful morning. We've got our coffee, and today we're going to get to work.
First off, we're going to try to level by hand some of the ruts we created. How's it going?
Any labor. Not for us. It's fine. Just trying to get these big ruts out. Now they've dried out a little bit.
So, remember how I said earlier we were going to be cutting brush today? Turns out we had a change of plans.
We've been burning these piles. There's a ton on the property.
And why are we burning it?
Look at it. It's an eyesore. There's no tires in there. I know you're going to ask.
Before anyone freaks out, we have a true trade professional on this.
How many years you been in the biz?
Apparently not long
enough. Burning versus, I guess, anything else.
It gets rid of stuff fast, whether you want it gone or not.
Okay, so we did want to kind of keep the old homestead that was here, but it was just falling apart. It was not in good shape, so we did plow it. This is what's left of it, but there is some wood in here that's definitely worth salvaging. So we're not gonna burn all of it. There's like some really cool beams. I'm gonna try to pick out what's garbage though and just burn that if we can. This right here, like even though it's rotted, it's still cool, worth it. Like this giant ass beam here. Like you don't really see this anymore. We'll try to save these. I see another one over there, big one right there. So those are definitely gonna get salvaged. But like these old pallets can definitely get burnt. We have no use for them. And because I'm a wimp, this is all I can carry at a time. Chunk, almost that entire pile actually. It's awesome. That, these are like the two left. There's some random stuff we'll burn later, but this needs to be done burning by the time we leave tomorrow. But you can see we could salvage these massive beams. They're pretty cool. Like, not as big as my hand. I guess that's not saying much, but we kind of got a pile of salvageable stuff here. That there's some old, like, metal roofing, a couple old plywood pieces, and all of these big old beams. Like, they're pretty cool. Can you even get these anymore?
Bold dimension?
Yeah.
Probably, but I'm assuming they're not cheap.
These are at least 6 feet. I got big, big beams. Okay, so. And now, just kind of cleaning up this little spot, working on a fire pit. I think the plan is eventually the whole pad, and we're gonna cut more into the bank eventually. This will just be a big parking turnaround area, so we can park trailers, and when people come out, they'll have a big, easy place to park. Just a nice, big, easy turnaround. To give you an idea of what we were working with the last time we were out here, our whole mountain is clay, like wet, sticky clay. Do you have anything to add?
It's a mess, but it's what we got.
Yeah. So when we dig into anything, this is what we are dealing with. And God forbid it rains. Pretty successful day.
I know. Looks much better.
Yeah, we did a number.
Yeah. It's good.
It does.
Better anyways.
We have definitely hit the afternoon wall here. Probably done with most projects for the day. It is hot. I think we're higher up in elevation than we think we are. Sun is beaten down. There is not a cloud in the sky. But we did really good today. This whole pile's gone. We're gonna be able to burn off that little bit there, some random scraps here. I mean, we've burnt down everything we've thrown onto that. We salvaged what we could. We'll probably be able to burn down most of that old firewood tonight. Not too shabby for a day out here. So now we're just relaxing and enjoying the peace and quiet out here. I can't let you go, baby. Take three of Welcome to Season 2. What are you going to see in this season?
A lot of cleanup and maybe some tears.
And probably some cursing. The bulk of the videos will probably be us cutting brush. You might see some other camping videos. I'm excited. We're going to start that segment. We don't really know what we're going to call it yet, though. We basically are going to start a weekly segment, I think, that's probably going to be filmed in our house. We get to tell all the cool stories of things we wished we'd had a camera for but didn't. But something a lot shorter and nicer sounding than that. So be on the lookout for that. We kind of know what we're doing now, maybe.
Yeah, we've got a rough outline.
Yeah. I guess what are our plans for the property?
I think just keep cleaning it up as best we can. Eventually, I don't know, maybe get a little cabin somewhere on the property. Mm-hmm. But right now, just enjoy it.
Mm-hmm.
Get out of town.
Mm-hmm. Our plans also involve figuring out the water situation. There isn't one.
Yeah.
So that's the situation.
Yeah. So we just learned today that previous owners were building a tire house, obviously. The county came and shut them down. So they just left.
They were out here. They had a bad winter. And they just left?
Left everything.
Everything.
Well, supposedly there was a building here already that somebody came and took.
So we know there was at least one owner. There had to have been a second
probably
owner far previous to that. So that's kind of cool. It adds some history to the property. Hopefully we're not cursed. Two failed homesteads. Like, are we going to be the third?
Yes, we are.
The access thing, we got it totally cleared up.
Oh, yes.
We had about a day of panic, though. We were worried about the easement. They sent us over
a copy of the original paperwork that described the easement.
From the 1930s. It was
unreadable. Like, it was like a photocopy of a photocopy of a photocopy of a photocopy of a stone tablet. Yes. But we got it all figured out. Turns out it's a county road, so we don't have to worry about easement issues. The tires, a couple good suggestions. Honest to God, we're probably about a month out from really doing anything with those. All our work is on this lower half of the property. Can't really use them to build a road, but it was a creative suggestion. I looked into it. Not really conducive with the dirt that we, like, just the way we're gonna do things. We're not gonna use them for any kind of structure.
No.
Realistically, I could see us using them as like a retaining wall, maybe. Maybe. Like I said, we're at least a month, 2 months out from dealing with them. So for now, they're just gonna be something that we laugh at every time we walk by, or cry every time we walk by, thinking of what we gotta do. We don't really wanna haul them off. I have a feeling we're gonna get charged if we haul them off, and there's a lot of tires up there. Way too many tires for that. There were people just commenting about how remote it really was gonna be. So we, like I said, we talked to the neighbor. He said they hardly have hunters. The logging property has a big gate across the road, so I mean, you can't drive up there. There is no public land access anywhere on this road. So there's just nowhere for outsiders to come. I don't think we will see a soul. And that neighbor has probably lived here for 20, or probably been out here 20 years. Only one time in like the last 10 years have they had any issues. Somebody broke into another neighbor's shed and stole some things, and they have not had a single incident since. So, but I truly don't foresee us having issues with people coming through, even though the county road does go through our property.
It ends right there.
Yeah, it ends like...
There's no reason to go back here.
There's... And even getting here, you have to go basically through a couple of farms, and there's no way you could accidentally end up here. But I really don't think we're going to have any issues with trespassers, with just random people coming through. That's nice. Mm-hmm. I guess it kind of is the upside of being surrounded by timber. Mm-hmm. Timberland as opposed to the public land. It was nice. There was a couple people that said this reminded them of when they started there. The support was sweet.
It is actually nice to hear.
Yeah.
Something reassuring from people.
It really is.
It does make you feel all warm inside.
Yeah. And it makes us feel like we're not just two idiots with a camera.
Even though we are definitely two idiots with a camera.
So it's nice. It's cool to know that there's other people in this little community.
Mm-hmm.
And for those who don't have a patch of dirt, everyone told us this, and we were like, yeah, off.
How many times did we give up? More than four.
Just keep your eyes peeled. You never know. You just never know. Like, this piece of property was just so nonchalantly under the radar, and look in places you wouldn't normally think you would look. We never dreamed of being this far south.
So yeah, expand your horizons.
Yeah. It's something, it's just, you never know. Things pop up all the time. And repossessed land owned by a Texan who's desperate to get rid of it. These things happen. Mm-hmm. Don't be afraid to call. So in honor of season 2, I think what we're going to do here is do a little bit of a contest. So the contest is, if you can guess however many tires encompass that structure up there without going over the actual number, we will send you a prize.
It'll be that many number of tires.
It'll be the tires. No.
And you have to pay for shipping.
But Price is Right rules. If you go over, you're out. May the best person win. This is also going to be kind of like an incentive to see who actually watches the videos all the way through. I will throw up some random clips we have of the tire house and just throw out a number. If you get close...
And she actually did spend the time and counted every single one of them.
Tire.
Well, I was out here breaking my back doing manual labor.
You were in the excavator.
Still.
But yep, we are here. Not going anywhere anytime soon. You just want to follow along, like, and subscribe. I mean, this property's already grown by leaps and bounds, so things should move fairly quickly. I mean, it's crazy, like, what we've already accomplished in two visits, or, like, two long visits to this property. So we're really excited.
Yeah.
It's a good feeling to come out and see a noticeable change at the end of the day.
Yeah, and then you have something to look forward to when you come back.
Yeah, like,
so
we're...
it keeps the motivation.
We're so excited.
Moving forward.
We're so excited.
As you can tell.
We're exhausted! I don't know how people do this every day. So, you know, please follow along. You know what to do. I don't have to say it.
Well, that's a wrap on this one. If you've made it this far, congrats! Don't forget to enter the giveaway for some cool stuff to celebrate this milestone. If you followed us from the beginning, you know how important this is to us. We've searched for a long time, and we're so happy that it's finally happened. Well, you know what they say, the best is yet to come. So be sure to like and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one. I've been looking for love so true. When I was down and down, along came you. Though you might be a liar and a cheat too. I just can't quit and... Riffy, say hi to your fans.
Anyways, so we had this all planned, and now we're redoing it. We're burning a slash pile right now about 10 feet from us, so.
It was doing just fine until we hit record.
Just an inferno. Oh, God.
Oh, this is going well. So, yeah, season two.
Season two!
Yay!
Oh, yeah. Hold on. We don't really know what we're going to call it yet, though.
Oh, Thought Thursdays.
Thought. Quick and now, 'cause I love you. Yes, I do. I can't let you go.